Zahvaljujem državnom sekretaru gospodinu Sada,
zahvaljujem generalnom
Kao što je rekao državni sekretar, ovo je bio prvi politički dijalog nakon stupanja na snagu Lisabonskog ugovora.
Since the Lisbon Treaty has entered into force.
Ja bih rekao da je i ovo posljednji politički dijalog za Crnu Goru u ovom
Also the last political dialogue for the Montenegro, at least, in this format.
You must have noticed that
this is also the first political dialogue
in the new format. The State Secretary, Mr. Losada, was representing the high representative for foreign and security policy. Until now, we always had our dialogues with the Troika,
and this is a new format for Montenegro, as Mr. Losada has already said. We are waiting for the stabilization and association agreement to enter into force, which will offer us new opportunities and new models for cooperation between Montenegro and the European Union.
Today's political dialogue, as you have already heard, ponovljeno je u stvari sve ono što sam čuo juče u odvojnim razgovorima koji sam imao sa visokim predstavnikom za spoljnu politiku bezbjednosti.
High representative Baroness Ashton that was held yesterday. So these were the most important issues that were discussed. Basically, Montenegro was recognized as a strong stability partner, and the thing that is also very important for all of us living in the region of the Western Balkans is that upon the end into force of the Lisbon Treaty, enlargement of the European Union is no longer in question. This also represents a large hope for us all because we have all set our European Union and NATO goals for ourselves. And I'm specifically very happy today because of the successes that we've had during the last year, and I'm speaking of progress that has been made in Montenegro and in our relations with the European Union. You know that we have managed to take a very important step, and also we answered all the complex questions in the questionnaire set by the European Union as regards membership of the Montenegro, full membership of the Montenegro Republic, and also it deals with the relations with our neighbors, our friends with Serbia and Macedonia, whose citizens were able to travel freely through the Schengen area, and there are many things to be proud of in addition to that. As you have already heard, we are already walking towards the new goals set for us in the year 2010. It is quite a difficult road to take, but certain progress is being made, and that's why I'm present here today in Brussels. We are discussing finalization of certain actions to be taken in respect of the issues related to the questionnaire, and also we are agreeing upon various visits of our experts and European Union experts in Montenegro. We are planning other activities together with the European Commission, and we all hope to be able to conclude all these activities successfully by the end of this year, and we also hope that Montenegro will see the end of this year together with the countries from the region, our neighbors, as entering into the new phase of the European integrations. So let me say once again, the Balkans that have been famous and infamous throughout the history and due to various qualifications, I may say, it has earned a specific place in European history and represents a part of Europe. So it also stands for certain cultural values and aspects, and we do believe that with our mutual efforts and with strong support by our European partners, we shall be able to attain our strategic goals and that the European Union will also be able to attain the goal of rounding up all the countries on this part of the continent.